Canines are one of the best, most versatile tools we have for protecting the homeland. But when it comes to explosive threats, many of our nation's detection canine teams have limited access to the latest resources to help them reach their full potential. The Department of Homeland Security Science and Technology Directorate is working to address this through its Regional Explosives Detection Dog Initiative, or REDDI, a nationwide effort to advance the knowledge and detection capabilities of canine teams within state and local law enforcement agencies.
We're trying to give the detection canine community the tools, techniques, and knowledge to better understand and train and utilize these dogs, to understand where their strengths and weaknesses are in their normal maintenance training. The REDDI program is really about understanding whether the maintenance training translates into operational proficiency.
They're showing us new ways that we can help train our dogs. They're putting us in realistic live scenarios, and they're able to bring that training here, setting up operational scenarios that maybe our dogs have never seen before.
My dog Canine Grim and I go to a lot of sporting events. We'll go to dignitary events and then different suspicious packages, bomb threats throughout the area. Some of the scenarios they've set up for us the last couple days, we've done some stadium seating where we have to search backpacks and packages, concession area, some VIP suites. We have a motorcade set up where we'll have to sweep the vehicles prior to a dignitary arriving. And there's also an odor recognition trial area.
When I first heard about the program, I thought, man, this would be excellent for our bomb guys, because as trainers and handlers, we get accustomed to just doing our own thing and not seeing what else is out there. It's opened up some eyes to some things. The training is outstanding. It is actually giving them things that we need to go back and work on.
So the idea is that each REDDI event, the participating handlers get their personal results, plus they can compare it against the results of the other teams that participated at that event. Then after conducting many events, we aggregate all of that data that will be compiled into a report to the Department of Homeland Security Science and Technology Directorate, and then disseminated to the law enforcement community.
That's what the S&T program is also able to do, is share what the weaknesses are and concerns and help them with that, as well as share what's working right.